Rise of the Tomb Raider is a much more technically advanced video game compared to the 2013 installment. With all the advancements in video game technology, the newer the game, the more demanding it becomes. Sometimes this is a good thing, and sometimes not so much. So let's say you finished Tomb Raider 2013 and would like to continue Lara's adventure, and then you start the game and see that the FPS numbers are not where you'd like them to be. Don't worry, in today's video I will show you how to improve the performance of Rise of the Tomb Raider in a few clicks of a mouse. This is not a typical benchmark video that will show you what it's like to play the game on certain hardware. This is a video that will show you what it's like to improve the performance of the game on certain hardware. Before we proceed with the optimization process, you will need to download and install the Low Specs Experience. The download link can be found in the description of this video. Low Specs Experience is a game optimization tool that I developed that will allow you to optimize your favorite games for maximum performance. So first of all, start the installation process for the Low Specs Experience. Once it's done, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut and select the optimization catalog. From the top of the menu, select the applicable digital platform and then select Rise of the Tomb Raider from the drop-down menu. Once that is done, press Load the Optimization Package. Now, if the Low Specs Experience does not automatically verify the installation location, simply select the location where your game is installed, press OK and the Optimization Control Panel will load. When the Optimization Control Panel loads, simply select the optimization presets and the resolution you would like to render your game at. This is something you will need to experiment on your own in order to see what works for a system the best. Once you decide which optimization presets and resolution you are going to use, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. Also, if you are not satisfied with what you see, you can always restore your game to default settings by choosing the Restore Default option. That's all from me for now. If you like what I do, please be sure to like the video and subscribe for more similar content. Anyway, I will see y'all next time.